Good afternoon, everybody. It's me, Rob, today with our Friday live quiz. So nice to be here and so good to see you out there watching. Hello, everybody. Yes, it is the Friday live quiz. As you know, we broadcast every Friday, either me or Dylan, with a quiz to test your English knowledge. And if you don't know the answers, it doesn't matter, because hopefully you might learn something today, which is fantastic. Of course, every quiz every week has eight questions to come today. We have the questions first, and then we have the answers later on. And today's theme is comedy. Yep, that's today's theme, comedy. Now, don't forget, we want to have lots of fun today. Lots of fun, but I'm afraid there are no prizes. It's just about having fun, taking part, telling us what you know about English, having a guess if you don't, and hopefully learning some things along the way. And as always with our live Friday quiz, we want you to like, comment, and share. Tell your friends, tell the world all about our Friday quiz, and do send me your comments, because they come here, they appear here at the side of my screen, which is why I sometimes look over here, because this is where all your messages are coming in from around the world. And as always, I like to know where you're watching from. Okay, so messages like that. Hello, great. Hello, everybody. Yeah, so do send me your shout out, say hello, tell me where you're watching from. I'd like to know before we start the quiz. Sad news, actually, very sad news. It's my last quiz today because I'm going to become an astronaut. Yeah, I'm going to train to be an astronaut and fly to the moon. So, yeah, no more quizzes for Rob. I'm really sorry to tell you that. Okay, so make sure you message me today, because I might not see you again, because I could be on the moon very soon when I train to be an astronaut. Okay, so sad news and good news. But the big news is today is the 1st of April. And that means it is April Fool's Day. And I fooled you. Yes, this is not my last quiz. No, I will be here forever. I am not going to the moon and I'm not going to be an astronaut. I was fooling you as a good example of April Fool's Day, which is what it is today. The day where we play jokes on people, we fool them, we make them believe things that aren't true, just for fun, not to be cruel, not to be horrible, but for fun, we play jokes and we call it April Fool's Day. Yeah, is it the same in your country? Do let us know. 1st of April, April Fool's Day. And I just fooled you. Ha ha. Okay. Stop mucking around, Rob. I think we should get on with our live Friday quiz from BBC Learning English with me, Rob, and eight questions to come on the theme of comedy. Okay, great. Are you ready to start playing the quiz? Let's just check your messages first. look, you see, Vice says happy April Fool's Day. Yes, I can see you. I didn't trick you, did I? I didn't trick you. You all knew it was April Fool's Day. Great. And we've got people from all over the world today. Let's see. I'm trying to keep up with your messages. They're coming in so quickly. We've got, every time I press a button, they move on. Right. We've got Sylvia in Poland. So hello to everyone in Poland. Who else we got here? Addie is in Peru. Hello, Peru. We've got Tangina in Bangladesh. So hello to you. Let's see. Oh, the messages are rolling in and coming in very quickly, so I'm trying to keep up with them. Mercedes in Ecuador, hello. Hassine is in Algeria. We've got Anne in Vietnam, hello. We've got Cooljoy in India, hello India. Sueli is in Brazil. That's great, isn't it? You really are an international audience today. Eva is in Taiwan, wonderful. Denise is watching from Mars. April Fools, yes. Let's have another look. Oh, Sanam's in Iran, hello. Hong Kong, Italy. Wow, you really are all over the place today. Well, wherever you are in the world, thank you so much for watching. I'm trying to get your name and your country up here on the screen. Apologies if I miss you out, but I'm going as fast as I can. Great, great. Hello, everybody. Hello, Myanmar. Argentina. Great. Okay. Wonderful. Yeah. I think we've almost got every country up there, haven't we? Yeah, I think we have. Okay, that's fantastic. As I say, thanks so much for watching, wherever you are in the world. Hello. I think we should begin our live Friday quiz. Don't you agree? 8 questions to come. Here is question number 1, or we call it round 1, on the theme of comedy. Do you know the answer to this question? Okay, have a look at that question. See if it makes any sense to you. The question is, if someone tells a joke or a short, funny story, we can call it what? A gig, a jib, a gag, or a blag? What's the answer? What is the correct answer? Gig, jib, gag, or blag? A joke or a short, funny story? What do you think the answer is? Tell me your answer. The messages come in just here on the screen, and I can tell you that... where's it gone? Oh, that's going so quickly. Juan says it's a gag. Eleanor thinks it's a gig. Rosanna says a gag. Okay. Bond thinks it's a gag. Rathin thinks it's a gig. Emanuela thinks it's a gig as well. Amit also thinks it's a gig. Anne thinks it's a gag. Claudio thinks it's a gag. Any other guesses, anybody? They're all coming in thick and fast. Wow. You're all desperate to have a go here. Julie thinks it's a gag. And Lynn thinks it's a gig. Okay. I'll give you the correct answers later on. Questions first, answers later in our comedy-themed live Friday quiz from BBC Learning English. Okay, let's move on to our next question. Round 2, see if you can read this one and see if you know the answer. Okay, the question is, I know a good joke. It's really fun. Now, is that correct English or incorrect English? I know a good joke. It's really fun. Correct or incorrect? What are people saying the messages from Facebook and YouTube? Right, well, Ardina says it's incorrect. Okay, Debbie says it's incorrect, whereas Ahmed says it's correct. Okay, another correct answer, or somebody saying correct there, whereas BI says it's incorrect. Susan is also saying it's incorrect. So a few of you are saying correct, but lots of you are saying it's incorrect. So this has got you thinking, hasn't it? Okay. Is a good joke fun? Is a good joke fun? Margie thinks that's correct. Correct use of English there. Okay. Right. Thanks for all your answers anyway. I will tell you the correct answer later on. Now, coming soon, by the way, we have a live guest. Yes, a special guest today. Who's it going to be? Find out very soon. He or she will have a special comedy question for you, okay, on our comedy-themed quiz. Right, well, that's question number 2. I think we now should move on to question number 3. Here we go. What do you think the answer is to this question? So, as I've been mentioning already, today is April Fool's Day, the 1st of April. But how do we write April Fool's Day? We've got 3 options here. A is April Fool's Day. Notice there's no apostrophe there. Then we have B, April Fool's Day, with an apostrophe after the S. Or is it C, April Fool's Day, with the apostrophe before the S? Has that got you thinking? What are people saying? Let's go to the message boards here and see what people are saying is the correct answer, the correct spelling here. Right, let's pick on Tra, who says C. It's option C. Let's go through. Here we go. Tamu says C as well. Lots of people saying C. Ifat says C. Mohammed is saying C. Anurada says it's C for cat. Thank you for the spelling there. C for cat. Bella's just saying, hello, teacher. I'm from Cambodia. Hello, Bella in Cambodia. Hope you're having a nice day. Right, so Debbie says B. Mariam says C. Lots of C's coming in here. You seem very confident it's C. Mako says it's C. So what is the correct spelling? Where should the apostrophe go? Nor thinks it's option C. And Wynn says it's C as well. Oh, lots of C's coming in. Okay. Right. Okay. Well, as always, I shall give you the answer later on. Okay. We've got the questions first, the answers later. I'm Rob, and this is the live Friday quiz from BBC Learning English. And we're talking about comedy today because it is April Fool's Day, where we're all supposed to be quite funny and tell jokes and do silly things. Okay, let's move on now to our next question, question number four. Right, on the theme of comedy, here it is. Have a look at this and see if you know the answer to this one. And do you know what that is in the corner there, that sad man? He's being a clown. Yes, there's an example of a clown there. Okay, the question is, though, which idiom does not describe a funny person? Which idiom or expression does not describe a funny person? Is it A, a laughing stock, B, a barrel of laughs, or C, a laugh a minute? A laughing stock, a barrel of laughs, or a laugh a minute? Which one of those phrases does not describe somebody who is funny, like this very unfunny clown here? Let's have a look at what you're saying. Hello, Irshad from Pakistan. Right. So we're looking at the phrase that's not about somebody being funny. Okay. Not about being funny. So Noor thinks it's a barrel of laughs. Whereas Nock says it's a laughing stock. Mohammed thinks it's option C. Amrit says C. Babel says C. Rodolfo also says C. A lot of you thinking it's C. We've got a few A's. Attic thinks it's A. Ang says A. Where's Evgeny? I haven't heard from him today. Where are you? And where's Bill? Carlos says C. Manisco says A. And Margie says A. Again says B. So wow, this has really challenged you, this one, I think. Yeah, you've got lots of different answers coming in. I will explain what the correct answer is later on, but thank you for taking part and having a guess. Even if you don't know, have a guess. So I shall tell you what the correct answer is later on. Okay, right, let's move on to question number five. Question number five is our special guest round. Yeah. So who is the special guest today? It is going to be... Here she is. Hello, Sam.
Hello. Hello, Rob. Hi, everyone. Happy Friday. Happy April Fool's Day.
Yes. Have you been fooled today?
No. Not yet. But are you going to fool me?
Because you've already
fooled the audience.
Actually, they do say that after 12 o'clock, after midday, if you try and fool somebody, you are actually the fool. It's only supposed to happen in the morning.
Really? Oh, I didn't.
So tradition goes.
Oh, that's funny. Well, it's after midday in the UK. So please,
I'm not going to trick you.
Please don't fool me.
And have you fooled anybody as well?
No, I'm terrible. I'm not, I don't have, in English we say a poker face. A poker face means that people can't see what you're thinking or doing. And I am terrible. It's very, very obvious from my face what I am doing. So I'm not good at fooling people, I'm afraid.
Okay. But you are a very good teacher, aren't you? So you have a question on the theme of fools, haven't you?
I do. Shall I ask it now? Is this my
moment?
Please do.
Yeah.
Okay. So hello, everyone. So our question today is around the word fool. So today is April Fool's Day, but what kind of word is fool? Is it A, a noun? Is it B, a verb? Or is it C, both? Are both possible?
Okay. Ooh, quite a challenge. Can I have that again, please?
Yes, of course you may. So question is, what kind of word is fool in April Fool's Day, but also in other contexts? Is it A, a noun? B, a verb? Or C, is it both? Can it be both a noun or a verb?
Can it be both? Okay. A few people saying hello to you, by the way, Sam.
Hello.
And somebody asked me, is Sam short for Samantha? Are you a Samantha?
That is correct. It is short for Samantha. Good knowledge. Well done.
Good. And somebody watched 6 Minute English this morning, which obviously you appear in quite a lot. So that's good.
I do. Oh, I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it was a good episode. Hi, cousin.
Anyway, I've got being April Fool's Day and we're talking about comedy, I have a joke for you.
Just a joke.
Just a joke. Do you know the answer to this? What does a house wear? What does a house wear?
What does a house wear? So wear like clothes? What does a house wear? Does a house wear a hat?
A hat.
A hat. Does a house wear a scarf?
Think more about language here. No.
Does a house wear? Wear?
No.
I have no idea.
Nobody else has given me the answer. Does anybody else know the answer to this joke? Let's have a look. I don't think anybody's got the answer.
Help me, audience. I clearly need more coffee today. What does a house wear?
What does a house wear?
It wears...
Does anybody else out there know? No, nobody knows the answer. They know the answer to your question, but they don't know
answer
to this joke. They don't know the answer to the joke. Okay, what does a house wear? It wears a dress.
Oh, that's very good.
Because when you have a house, you have an address, don't you? Wear the street
that's
name.
And very the address. Good. I like it. So address spelled ADDRESS. Very exactly. Good.
It's a bit of a play.
I would never have guessed that today.
It's not Friday. Address.
My brain is, very good. I like it, Rob. That made me laugh. Good. Thank you.
Good. Excellent. Well, thank you for joining us.
My pleasure.
You go and rest and have a good weekend.
I will. And you. Happy weekend, everyone.
And when will we see you again?
Probably the next 6 Minute English, I think. That's usually where you find me these days.
Every Thursday.
So I look forward to speaking to you then.
Okay. Thanks, Sam. Thank you for your question.
Good luck. My pleasure. Enjoy the rest of the quiz. Bye, everyone.
Bye-bye. Bye. Okay, great. There's Sam there with her question as well. Okay, and I'll give out the answer to that later on. Right. I hope you like the joke, by the way. Do you get it? What does a house wear? A dress? Never mind. Get your friends to explain it. Right. Let's move on now. Oh, by the way, just to remind you, this is, of course, BBC Learning English. And this is our live Friday quiz with me, Rob, today. And we're on the theme of comedy today, partly because it's April Fool's Day. Now, as I said, we're going on to question number 6 now. We have 8 questions. This is our 6th question, and here it is. Have a look at that and see if you know the answer to this question on the theme of comedy. And this is to do with that very funny show that used to be on called Friends. Are you a fan of Friends? Do you like Friends, the TV show? Now, how can we describe Friends? Of course, it's a TV show, but we can also call it what? Because it was very funny. What do we call it? A rom-com, a sitcom, or a drama-com? A rom-com, a sitcom, or a drama-com? What could we call Friends? The TV show we're talking about. Not our Friends, but the TV show Friends. What would you call it? Right, let's have a look what you are saying on the message boards here. Javier is saying sitcom. Lynn is saying a sitcom. Mubashir is also saying sitcom. You sure it's not a rom-com? I wonder. Randa's saying C. It's a drama com. Let's have another look. We've got lots of B's coming in here. Key says sitcom. Vicky is saying sitcom. Ibital is also saying sitcom. Yilin also says, I learned it from Dylan. Oh, has Dylan been teaching you this already? I hope not. Okay. Sitcom. Amnella is saying rom-com is a romantic comedy. So would you call it a rom-com? There was a romance in Friends, wasn't there? What a great show, wasn't it? It was on for years and years. And of course, they're repeating it now. And the characters look very young, don't they, in the show? Okay. Right. Well, lots of sitcoms coming in, but a few other options as well, like a C there. Okay. Well, as I said, I'll give you the answers very soon. Questions first. Here comes question number seven. Question number seven, and it's this one. Have a look at that and see if you know what the answer is. What do you call something that is extremely funny? Something that's very funny. We call it hilarious. Yes, that's the right word. But how do you spell hilarious? Is it A, H-I-L-A-R-I-O-U-S? Is it B, H-I-L-A-I-R-I-O-U-S? Or is it C, hilarious, H-I-L-L-A-R-I-O-U-S? Which is it, A, B, or C? What do people think out there? Right. Lenka thinks it's C. But Caro thinks it's A. Marcy says it's option A as well. We've got a few A's coming in here. How do we spell it? Amelia also thinks it's A. Lou thinks it's C. Hill with two L's. What are other people thinking? Got lots of answers. I'm putting them up on the screen here just so you can see your name in lights. Okay. A's, a few C's, but mainly A's coming in. Kader says A should be the correct option. Well, as I said, I'll tell you very soon what the correct answer is. A few more C's there. Okay, so this is all about the spelling of the word hilarious. All right. Thank you for your answers. Keep them coming in. As I said, I'm seeing them on the side of my screen here, which is where I'm looking, just to see them all coming in here. And don't forget as well to say hi and tell me where you're watching from. I'm very nosy and I like to know where in the world you are watching from. I am here in my house in the UK. Where are you watching from? Okay, final question coming up. Here we go. Question number eight, round eight, we might call it. And this is the final comedy question coming up. Who is that? Who is that lady? I'm sure you know. Yeah, it's Rebel Wilson, or a sketch of Rebel Wilson, who's in lots of funny films. So what can we call her if she's in funny films? She's a great comedian actor, a great comic actor, or a great comical actor? Is she a great comedian actor, a great comic actor, or a great comical actor? What's the best use of English there? Which word fits best and best describes her? Let's have a look what you're saying on the message board. And Lou thinks it's A, comedian. Whereas, let's press the button here. Yeah. Chomponut also thinks it's comedian. Maria says Brazil. I assume you're watching from Brazil. That's not the answer. Hello, Brazil. Sai says it's comedian. Okay. Jada thinks it's comic. Mohammed thinks it's a comedian. Ollie also thinks it is a comedian. We got shout outs from Thailand. Hello to everybody in Thailand. Ibizar also says be comic. And let's have a look. Vanessa says comedian. Marina is watching in Serbia. So hello, Serbia. Zor says comic. Mm-hmm. Okay. What else we've got going on? A comic. It should be an adjective. That's from Gedaleros in Ethiopia. Hello, Ethiopia. Nar says A. All right. We really have got mixed opinions here, which is great because it means it's quite a challenge. And we want to challenge you as well as having fun. Okay. Great. Well, thank you for all those answers. There are your 8 questions on the theme of comedy. And I hope you're having fun on this live Friday quiz. And I think it's about time we had the answers. Okay. Are you ready for the answers on this live quiz? Let's see if you were right. Round 1, question 1. I asked you this. If someone tells a joke, like I just did to Sam, or a short kind of funny story, we can call it a what? Gig, jib, gag, or blag? The answer was gag. Yeah, the correct answer was gag. Did you get that right? Do tell me on the messages. Yeah, the correct answer was gag. Now, a gig is like a concert when a band plays. You go to a gig to see a band play. A jib is a part of a crane, actually. The bit that sticks out is a jib, okay? Also, blag is when you exaggerate something. You might blag about your qualifications. You might say you're the greatest person in the world. You're blagging a bit. But C was a correct answer, a gag. A gag is a joke or a short, funny story. And you might go to a comedy show and see a stand-up comic. We call them a stand-up comic because they stand up and they're standing there and telling jokes, okay? They are telling gags. So who got that right? Who got that right? Do tell me. Don't worry if you didn't get it right. We're playing just for fun today, but it's nice to know who is getting that right. If you didn't get that right, hopefully you've learned something. Okay. Yilan says, no, I didn't get that right. Oh, dear. Never mind. Somebody was asking about what does gig mean. A gig is a musical performance, an informal musical performance, not like an orchestra of classical music. If you go and see a band play, we often say we're going to a gig, as opposed to a gag, which is the correct answer here. Okay, who got it right? Mara got it right, whereas NL didn't. Rylan got it right, and Alberto got it right. So well done. And oh, look at this one. We've got Yassine got it right from Morocco. Wonderful. Good. Somebody's asking, is gig short for giggle? Not in this case. No. There is the word giggle when you go, that's a giggle, but gig is not the short of giggle. Okay, great. All right, well done. Let's move on to the answer now for question number 2. Hope you're having fun, by the way. This question was about fun, wasn't it? I think I was trying to trick you, though. I was asking you, I know a good joke. It's really fun. Is that what we say? Is it correct or incorrect? Well, I can tell you now that the answer is incorrect. It's incorrect. We don't say the joke was fun. We say the joke was funny. Funny. Okay. Fun. We use the word fun. It's a noun word, and we use it to say, talk about things we enjoy, give us pleasure and enjoyment. So going to the park was fun. Going to the fun fair was fun. Going to the theme park was fun. Seeing my friends was fun. It was enjoyable. But when we're talking about something that makes us laugh, we use an adjective, and that is the word funny. Something that makes you laugh is funny. F-U-N-N-Y. Funny. So did you get that right? Let's have a look. Somebody's saying they joined the quiz late. Don't worry. This quiz gets repeated and put up again on Facebook and on YouTube, so you can watch it again later. Who got that question right? Let's have a look. Sylvia got it right. Let's move on to some more answers coming in. We're still getting some answers from the first question. Who got this one right? Quick. Let's have a look. Slight delay on the answers coming in here. Right. Faisal got that right. Well done. And William in South Korea got that right. It's funny joke collocation. No, it's not in this case. A funny. Oh, I see what you mean. A funny joke. You could say a joke is funny, a funny joke, but then jokes are funny. So you wouldn't really say a funny joke because jokes are meant to be funny. So you don't really say a funny joke. You can say it, but a joke is funny anyway by its nature. Okay, let's have another look. Yassine says she got it right. Well done. And Lorenzo got 2 out of 2. And Mashai says funny jokes help you to chill out. Yes, but it's good to laugh, isn't it? So just to somebody's asking me just to clarify, fun, a noun, is a word we use when something is enjoyable. Eating an ice cream. Actually, that's not a very good example, eating ice cream. Going to the cinema is fun. But when something makes you laugh, we describe it as funny. Funny. Okay. All right. Good. Let's move on now to our next answer to question number 3. And I asked you that today, as we know, is a day where people trick each other. And it's called April Fool's Day. But this question was all about apostrophes. Where do we put the apostrophe in April Fool's Day? And the answer is B, after the S, after the S. Were you right? Do tell me, April Fool's Day. Now, this is, I say, a question about apostrophes. If we were just talking about a plural word like fools, there's lots of fools out there, then we wouldn't have an apostrophe. We just say F-O-O-L-S, like we might say to somebody or a group of people, you're all fools. That's plural. But this is about a possessive apostrophe belonging to something or a group of people. And April fools are a group of people. Okay. Let's put it very simply. It's a group of fools who get tricked on the 1st of April. So it's a group. It's a possessive apostrophe for plural nouns. Okay. If there was just one fool, then we would put the apostrophe before the S. If it belonged to one April Fool today, we would put the apostrophe before the S. Now, people often get this mixed up, and you'll probably see it written a lot like option C. You know what they mean, but the official correct answer is B. The apostrophe comes after the S because it's plural. Whereas if it's a singular April Fool, we put it before the S. Okay, who got that right? Hello, Bill. Nice to see you. You got it wrong, but thank you for having a go. C looks like the correct answer. Yes, if it belongs to one fool, but with lots of fools here, plural fools. Hada had said C. Tawu says, let me tell you a funny story. what else? Sarah's got 3 out of 3, so well done. And Ibitzal has also got it right. And Nar's got it wrong. Doesn't matter. It's great to have a go, isn't it? Great to have a go and take part. All right, let's move on to the answer to our next question. And this is question number 4. And I asked you which idiom or expression does not describe a funny person. Yeah, like the guy there, he's not really funny, is he? He looks pretty sad, actually. Okay, which expression is not a funny person? Do we describe them as a laughing stock, a barrel of laughs, or a laugh a minute? And the correct answer was C. Was A. I'm joking. It's A. Did you get that right? A laughing stock. Yeah, let me know if you got that right. That's because B, a barrel of laughs, does describe somebody who is very funny. Makes you laugh, maybe. It's good to be in their company. They are, we call, a barrel of laughs. Yeah. A barrel of laughs is somebody who is very funny. They make you laugh. And a laugh a minute can describe somebody who's always telling jokes. They're very funny. Do you know people like that? A laugh a minute. They're always making you happy, always making you laugh with their jokes and their stories. So that describes people who are funny. But a laughing stock is unfortunately not. If you are a laughing stock, people laugh at you for the wrong reasons. They're not laughing at you because you are funny. It's because you've done something stupid. So it says here, a laughing stock is a person who is the subject of mockery after they make a mistake. So, you know, you might, I'm thinking of an example, you might fall over in the street, or you might drop something. You have an ice cream, you drop it, and you've made a real mess. Everybody laughs at you. You're a laughing stock. They're laughing at you. They're not laughing with you. They're not laughing at your jokes. They are laughing at your misfortune. So you are a laughing stock. So that was the correct answer. A. Who said A out there? Kaur said A. Badari says A. Let's go. Let's have another look. I'm trying to get the answers here. Latanya's got 3 out of 4, so you're doing very well. Adam said it was A, so well done. Emilio says you said laughing stocks. You got 1 out of 8 right, so well done. Danielle says idioms are very interesting to know well. Yep. It's good to know English idioms because we use them all the time. If you can get them into your English conversation, it's fantastic. It'll sound even more like a natural English speaker. Ahmed's got it right, so well done. Amir says appreciation. Yeah, well, it's appreciated that you are watching. And Tangina's got 2 out of 8. So a lot of you are doing very well on our live Friday quiz with me, Rob. Today, Friday the 1st of April. Let's move on now to round 5. This was Sam's, our special guest. Sam came on with a question, and this was about fool. The word fool in April Fool's Day. Is it a noun? Is it a verb? Or is it both? And the answer was both. You can use fool in both ways. Did you know that? Did you get that right? Yeah. It's a verb and a noun. Okay. Yeah, now let's give you examples. If you use it as a noun, you could say, I feel like a fool for believing him. He always lies. I feel like a fool. A fool is a noun. Okay, so you can use it as a noun. As a verb, you could say, he fooled me into believing it was true. So that's using it as a verb, to fool. He fooled me into believing it was true. So it can be used as a noun, a fool, or a verb, to fool. So, did you get that right? Did you say both? Let's have a look. Kim said right. Anne said right. Rabina says I was right. Ahmed says don't fool me. Emilio, 5C. So you got 2 out of 8. Well done. Okay, we've got some good answers coming in here. You're doing very well today. Yeah. A verb and a noun. Yes, so fool is a verb and a noun. I got it right as well. So well done. And a hello from Myanmar there. Hello, Myanmar. Okay, let's move on now to question number 6. We're talking about the show Friends. It was such a funny show. Yeah. What kind of show was it though? Was it a rom-com, a sitcom, or a drama-com? And the answer was sitcom. Yeah. It was a sitcom. Were you right about that, calling it a sitcom? Yeah, this is an abbreviation of the expression situation comedy. So a comedy, as in a funny show, in a set in a situation. The situation was their flat, wasn't it? It was all about their life, more or less, in their flat. A situation comedy. So a comedy show that's kind of set somewhere. It's not lots of little sketches or somebody telling jokes. It's a drama, isn't it? A funny drama situated somewhere. A rom-com, as somebody said earlier, is a romantic comedy. We have a lot of films that are rom-coms. There's lots of romance. Will they, won't they get together? Will they get married? That's a rom-com. There was some romance in this, but this is more, I think, a better description is a sitcom. And drama-com, we don't really use that expression at all. That's made up, a drama-com. It's a drama, but it's not a drama-com, not a drama-comedy. It is a drama-comedy, but we don't use the expression drama-com. Sitcom probably is the best example, a situation comedy, a situation comedy. Okay, who said that? Situation plus comedy. Someone's asking, yes, a comedy, it's funny. Situation, where is it set? It's situated somewhere. Okay. Right, how do we get on? Let's have a look. Somebody's saying they think C. Well, I've told you the right answer is B. The answer is B. I thought it's number C. No. Yeah, somebody's saying a romantic comedy is like a love story, like Ghost. Yeah, good example of a rom-com. What was it? Was there comedy in Ghost? Depends how you looked at it. Manuel, you got it right, so well done. Somebody says they like watching, Evgeny likes watching Keeping Up Appearances. This is a very old-fashioned sitcom now, situated at home, about a very bossy lady, because they were trying to keep up their appearances in the neighborhood. They wanted to be seen as something special. It was called Keeping Up Appearances, and it was very funny. I'm glad you like that, Evgeny. We've got B there, sitcom. Yeah, great. Ghost is a drama. Yes, it was a drama film, wasn't it? I'm not quite sure if it was much comedy in there, to be honest. Ugo likes Friends in the Office. Yes, I like The Office. Very funny indeed. And another one I like to watch with my family is a comedy called Modern Family. Has anybody watched Modern Family out there? That's very funny indeed. Okay, good. Anyone heard of Modern Family out there? Do tell me. Okay, good. Let's move on now. Well done, by the way, if you got this right. But don't worry if you got them wrong. We're all having fun on this comedy theme show. Right, question number 7 about spelling. What do we call something that's very funny? Well, the word is hilarious. That means it's really funny. But how do we spell it? And the correct spelling was the first one. H-I-L-A-R-I-O-U-S. Hilarious. Did you get that right? Did you know that? Please do tell. Yeah. Okay, you got it right. Well done. Tangina's got it right. Cor got it right. Ah, good. Rocchio, I love Modern Family. Yeah, good. Tito got it right from Vietnam. Wonderful. Yeah, brilliant. Oh, let's move on. Oh, come on. There you go. Hilarious. You spelt it correctly. Yusuf got it right. And Anne got it right as well. Okay, good. Well done, everybody, for getting that right. If you didn't, don't worry. Now you know how to spell the word hilarious. Hilarious. Very funny. Okay, let's move on to the answer to our final question, round 8. By the way, don't disappear. I have a joke for you before you go. We looked at Rebel Wilson and said that she is a great something actor. Is she a great comedian actor? A great comic actor or a great comical actor? And the answer was, or the correct or best answer is B. She is a great comic actor. And I think that tricked a few of you, didn't it? A lot of you said comedian. And a comedian is somebody who is funny and somebody who tells jokes. But we use that word on its own. Somebody is a comedian. A funny person is a comedian. But here we were describing what kind of actor she is. And so therefore we use the word comic, an adjective to mean funny, a funny actor, a comic actor, a comic actor. So the correct answer, or the best fit, was B. She's not a comedian actor. A comedian is a person in their own right. So we don't say she's a comedian actor. We can say she's a comedian or she is a comic actor. Now, comical is also another adjective which describes somebody who is or something that is funny. We don't tend to put it with actor. We don't say she's a comical actor. We can describe her as being comical, so she's funny. We can describe actions that people do as comical. You know, the way you rode your bike in a wobbly line was very comical, in a comical way. So we can describe things that are funny as comical. But when we're referring to a person or an actor, we say they are a comic actor, or even just a comic. You can even say it on its own. Comic also, of course, can describe a magazine that's full of cartoons. That's a comic. That's a noun then. Something that's full of cartoons is a comic. But here, so think of that as being funny. Lots of cartoons is funny. But here we are using the adjective as an actor, or we can call her an actress if you want as well. A female actor can be known as an actress, but often we now use the word actor to refer to male or female actors. Right. Who got that right? Some people are saying it's a difficult question. Well, I don't want to make it too easy. Being a comic actor is quite challenging. I agree. Champonuts got 4 out of 8. So one, well done. Neo said, I like these quizzes. Always learn something new. Hooray. We want you to learn things. That's wonderful. That's wonderful. Cool was right with that one. Teresa is just waking up in Sao Paulo and saying good morning. Good morning, Sao Paulo. Yeah, somebody else telling me that you've got 5 out of 8. Well done to Latanya, who's got 6 out of 8. Lily got 0 out of 8. Doesn't matter. I hope you've learned something today. Super said 6 out of 8. So that's a good score. And what else? Somebody's telling they like Michael McIntyre. He's a very funny stand-up comedian. He stands up and tells jokes and does funny things, doesn't he, Michael McIntyre? Ricky Gervais is another example of a comic actor. He doesn't tend to tell jokes. So he does tell jokes, but he's probably best known just for being a funny kind of actor. All right, we've got some good scores, and it's brilliant you've all been taking part. Yassine says, we learned so much today. So you're very welcome, Yassine. I'm glad you learned something. This quiz is every Friday. It's about having fun, testing your English knowledge. And if you don't know it, you learn new things. Now, let me tell you a little joke because we're talking about comedy. Did you hear about the first restaurant to open on the moon? Yeah. Have you heard about the new restaurant that's opened on the moon? Yeah, it's got great food, but no atmosphere. That's my last joke for you today. I won't tell any more. I am not a comedian or a comic actor. I am Rob, and it's been great you've been watching today. I hope you've enjoyed the show. As I said, we are here every Friday. Dylan's back next week with our live quiz at 1:30 UK time here on Facebook and YouTube. And it's coming to you from BBC Learning English. And it's great you've been watching. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've learned a lot today. I hope you've had fun, and I hope you have a great weekend. All right. Don't forget you can watch us again. We put the repeat up on YouTube and Facebook. So watch again and tell your friends. Okay. I've been Rob. You've been fantastic. Bye, everybody. Take care and have fun. See ya.